future is now.
So I hope you now can hear me. Check, check. Sorry about this. Technical fault. we prepared today. Again, I'm Christian. We are here from the showroom in Dresden. And we are streaming live from the Madwix showroom. We changed the whole situation here in the showroom from yesterday to today. So sorry about this one. I hope now you can hear me. Today's topic is Madwix Radar. Madwix Radar is a new piece of software we developed over the last years. It's about RDM, and I want to change my position to a new position. So here behind me, you can see the LEDs from HeraLED from Turkey. Now these LEDs are supporting RDM. And of course, DMX. We got these fixtures from HeraLED from Turkey for our tests of Madwix Radar. So we have them in the showroom, and you can see the lights from the fixtures. The topics for this week is, yesterday we saw the 2020 March update. It's on YouTube. So you go to youtube.com/Madwix_team and you search for the live streams, you can find this and watch them later. Today's topic is Madwix Radar. Tomorrow, same time at 4 p.m., we have a new piece of hardware. We've talked about yesterday in the beginning, but tomorrow I get more into details about this new hardware. Friday, last live session for this week, 4 p.m., same time, Madwix 5.3, all the new features. And of course, a big Q&A session. I guess this will be a big Q&A session. So today's topic are DMX 512, ArtNet and RDM. Then some user feedback about Madwix Radar. We will have a live demo of Madwix Radar. We have a summary and a Q&A session like yesterday. So at the very end, you can ask me any questions and I try my best to answer all the questions. So let's start. DMX 512, it's a unidirectional communication protocol. And DMX 512 standard is 5-pin. So I know that outside of this office, a lot of guys and a lot of production companies and a lot of fixtures and a lot of lights have 3 pins, but 3-pin standard was invented or was for audio and not for lighting. So the industry standard for DMX 512 is 5-pin XLR connectors. All the Madwix products, all the Madwix devices, hardware products have 5-pin connectors on the backside. DMX 512 was invented in the year 1986, and the industry standard was really in the 1990. So DMX 512, the industry protocol, is on the market now since 30 years. It's a very robust protocol used on the big stages, in nightclubs, everywhere around the world. Very robust protocol to transmit the data, the light information from a computer or lighting desk to the fixtures, to the devices. ArtNet. ArtNet basically is a communication protocol that allows you to send the DMX 512 data via network. So Here you can send from the computer over a standard network cable the DMX512 data via TCP/IP protocols to your ARTNET node. And the ARTNET node has DMX outputs on the backside, and the ARTNET node outputs the DMX data. So basically, very easy to understand. ARTNET is DMX512 via network. ARTNET is invented by Artistic License. Artistic License made this public. It's public domain. It's published. So all the control guys, all the lighting control guys, the interfaces, the hardware devices, the software, the lighting controllers, the lighting desk was the word I'm searching for, the lighting desk, they can use and implement ARTNET into their consoles, into their media servers, because it's public domain, it's free of charge, it's a standard, no license fees, nothing. So in the Matrix software and also in Radar, ARTNET is implemented. Matrix Radar supports ARTNET like ART poll reply. This we use to find the Matrix Stellar devices automatically in the network. So again, ART poll reply for finding the Matrix Stellar devices in the network. Matrix Stellar, you will get some information at the very end of my presentation. Now to RDM. RDM stands for Remote Device Management. And in comparison to DMX512, this is a bidirectional communication. So basically, if you develop an RDM product like Matrix Radar can send information to the fixtures, and the fixtures or devices, sorry, or the devices can answer. So Radar sends information to the RDM devices. RDM device information came back like DMX channel, ARTNET universe, DMX personality, or even sensor values like temperature, voltage, things like this. With Matrix Radar, the ANSI standards E1.02 and ANSI E1.37-1 are implemented. So it supports all RDM parameters over ARTNET, often called ARTRDM. All fixture parameters, the PIDs, so the IDs for set and get are supported. And if a manufacturer has implemented an own manufacturer-specific parameter, also this is included in Radar. So you will see the manufacturer-specific parameters as well. If the manufacturer or when the manufacturer has used the standard RDM implementation. So conclusion, RDM, Remote Device Management, Matrix Radar is bidirectional in comparison to DMX512. DMX512 is unidirectional, so you can send a signal from the software to a light. With RDM, you get information back from the device, like the HERA LED tubes in the background. Now, we start a video which explains Matrix Radar very well.
What is it?
An LED.
It's gone.
I'll fix it.
Wow, a matrix.
Beautiful, right?
Yeah, but it seems...
I'm on it. Done.
I have a dream.
What's that?
A skyscraper wrapped in dynamic light ambience.
Like that?
Holy, exactly like that. But how can I be sure that everything is working fine?
I'll get and tell you in 2 days.
How about in 2 hours?
Impossible.
No, it's not. We made it possible. Introducing Matrix Radar. Every great light design starts with your idea. This idea is becoming a great vision, including more and more LEDs, and only the sky's the limit. But to get it right, you face two major challenges: setting it up and keeping it running. Think of the countless lights which need to be set correctly to do their job. Think of all the time and manpower you invest to ensure every single light operate consistently over its lifetime. That's why more and more DMX lighting fixtures are equipped with RDM and its two-way communication. Devices are not only receiving instructions, but also sending out feedback. This enables you to use remote monitoring, remote configuration, and remote management. Based on this technology, we are now introducing a software that enables you to set up and monitor your devices fully automatically. We call it Madrix Radar. Madrix Radar is the complete toolbox for managing your devices. It includes automatic fixture patching, fully automatic 24/7 device monitoring, and automatic email notifications. With Madrix Radar, you will build a database of past sensor data and see trends of device parameters, such as temperature and operating hours. Exchange fixtures that are likely to fail soon before they do, and this way avoid costly maintenance revisions. Simplify and speed up your setup process. Stay in control of your project at any time, in any place. Transform the way you run your lighting projects. Unleash the full potential of RDM. Madrix Radar.
So, to summarize, Madrix Radar is fully automatic 24/7 device monitoring. It's automatic email notifications. And with the help of Madrix Radar, you can unleash the full potential of RDM. You see a beautiful background here in this picture of a skyline. So imagine you have Madrix software running, controlling all the pixels on the buildings. Madrix Radar, and this is unique in this industry, can run in the background and monitoring 24/7 your devices fully automatically. Again, Radar runs as RDM software in the background and can the software already. This is Roberto is from Mexico. He is our distributor in Mexico, and he is telling us by email that this technology is new for in this industry, industry leading and using the big data license. I will come more into details about the big data as well. It's a game changer. Here, Bruno Hediger is from Switzerland. He's telling us beautiful software, super easy to use, fast, cool software, very well done. This picture, I want to tell you a story why we developed Madrix Radar. Imagine you are a project company and you are responsible for these kind of media facades. So you are developing products, you are installing such products on buildings like this. Imagine you have a beautiful architectural project in Turkey, in Dubai, somewhere in the world. Now imagine a fixture fails at the building and you are responsible to replace and to repair the fixture. How expensive is replacing a fixture on a TV tower like this one in a 30th floor, very tall? How expensive is this? So you maybe go to the tower, you're replacing the fixture, and a week later you go back to your office, you have replaced the fixture, very expensive process. A week later, the owner of a TV tower or the government is calling you, there's another broken light on the tower, you have to fix this. So you go back to the TV tower, you're replacing another fixture, which was maybe two rows below the other one. The reason why these fixtures are failing are mostly the same. It's overvoltage, undervoltage, too much temperature, so too high temperature or too low temperature. So when the sun is shining on the TV tower the whole day, maybe the LEDs are getting way too hot. And using radar and big data license, you can take a look into the history. You can see all the sensor data. So you see the temperature values for each individual light on the building, on the TV tower, or voltage, things like this. So Now we go to a demo. So I'm changing my position again. We are going now to the radar software. As you can see, the situation is the following. We have radar running on the left side, Matrix running on the back side. And in a few seconds, you will see picture in picture, the LED wall, which is running from the Matrix software. So the content comes from the Matrix software. And radar is analyzing in the background the RDM information. So I start now with the presentation of Matrix Radar. At the left side, when you start for the first time the software, Matrix Radar shows you a beautiful image. You can change between this kind of dark user interface, and also you can change to a light user interface. So you can decide, I want to have a dark user interface or a light interface. On the left side, you see a devices list. Now, Matrix Radar is designed for the operation with not one or two or five or 10 fixtures. It's designed for an operation with thousands of fixtures, RDM fixtures. So here you have a list of all the devices which are in the network. When you start Matrix Radar for the very first time, you have also a filter. And you will see this filter during my presentation at several times. So when you here click into the search filter, you can filter again, Matrix Radar designed for thousands of fixtures. So to find if a device here in the list, you can filter. So let's type in exhibition, for example. So as you can see, it's a live filter. You see now only the devices which have exhibition here in the name. I can also delete this and I search for an IP address, for example. I press 0.150 and now I see only the devices which have an IP address of 150. Okay, so this is filtering, cool for when you have connected thousands of devices. Now we go through this list. So you see here the interface IP address of the device. You see the short name, you see a long name, and here you see the interface firmware, a device label, and in the device label, you see a pen. So this pen reminds you that you can change the names here. So here you can change values. So I can click here into this one, and I can change this to another one, or let's say 100, press enter. Now radar sends this information to the fixture. It takes a while, and then this will be saved on the device, on the device. So here is the unique ID. Sometimes it doesn't work, sometimes it works. It's because of RDM specifications. So here you have unique ID, you have ESTA manufacturer, you have identify. If I press identify, I'm searching for a fixture here like this one. And I now press identify, yes, and enter. The fixture will blink. So you will see on the far right corner of our DMX RDM installation, a blinking fixture. This is a fixture you have now identified. I can also click no here and enter, and then it stops blinking. You have the DMX universe, DMX start channel, so you can already patch here in this view. So you can change start addresses for the fixtures, and the fixtures have, of course, DMX personalities. You will see a complete list of the personalities here as well. So you can change the personality here as well. On the right side, you see parameters. Now these parameters are coming from the fixture. I go to the third one, this one. Here on the right side, you see the IP address again, the long name, ESTA manufacturer, identify, DMX universe, same similar information, plus an additional one, the number 28. This is L80 lumen remaining hours. And this is get manufacturer specific parameter. So this is what I told you in the very beginning. Magix Radar can show you also specific manufacturer information in this view. Now we go to, also here you have, of course, the filter. So you can search for, let's say, lumen. See, same here. And now we go to sensors. This is the interesting stuff. Now the HeraLED fixtures have four sensors connected, as you can see. Sensor number one is called PCB temperature. Sensor two, we have regular temperature, we have input voltage and regular out voltage. In this graphical view, you see the current value. So the black line represents the current value, which is right now 28 point something degrees Celsius. You see 28.5 degrees Celsius. You have also information about the normal range, maximum range, things like this. So when I click here, for example, to the temperature value, at the very bottom of the software, here in this part, you see now the big data information. I can zoom out. So here I can take a look into the past. On the left side, you see we have now information from the 23rd of March until the 4th of April, which is in a few days. So here you can take a look into all the sensor values from the last days, weeks, months, or even years. So here you see all the sensor values, the temperature values, and I take a look in today's value. Today in the morning, I came to the Madrix office at 7 a.m. and 10 minutes, and I turned on the lights. So here the first record of Madrix Radar today is 7 a.m. in the morning and 10 minutes, the lights turned on. Then, because the lights turned on, the temperature, the regular temperature increased. And here I had an idea. So I had an idea to turn on all the lights in a white color, because if you turn on white, all the R, G, and B LEDs are on. And then, of course, the temperature value is increasing. And you can see this here. So here it's 44.7 degrees Celsius, still not a problem for an LED. And then after this, I shut down. I sent the black from the Madrix software. And as you can see, the values are going down. So here, with big data, you can take not only a look into the current values, you can take a look into the history. So you see trends of the devices, you see trends of sensor data. So this could maybe change the situation with a broken fixture. So here you would see if a device is getting way too hot, and maybe if you change the fixture to another one, you can take a look, and here the fixture looks different. It's maybe the fixture is on the backside or side side of a building, or the sun is shining directly on the fixture. As you can see, you can monitor and see all the values in real time. Then, of course, Madrix Radar supports events. So again, it's 24/7 monitoring. Madrix Radar runs in the background during live operation. Again, this is unique in this industry. Madrix Radar can send you emails. We've configured here an email. We created a Gmail account. This is free of charge. Everybody can do this. We type in our password, and we send every 30 minutes a status report starting at the 30th of March. This is the subject. In the subject, you can type in your project. So you could type in, this is my project in Dubai. This is the project in Turkey, whatever you want. And in categories, you can define at which action Madrix Radar sends you an email. So Madrix Radar sends you an email if something critical occurs here. So you see it displaying the error, and also it sends you an email. It can also send you an email just for information. If you don't want this, just press delete. Now, Madrix Radar sends you only an email if something critical occurs, not in the case of information also not in case of validation. You can also create new categories by yourself. Also, this is possible. Now, in the events, you see a list of all the RDM events. Also here, you have search, the filter, because also you see is a lot of RDM information, a lot of events which can happen, right? So let's do a filter here again. I type in sensor, and I scroll a little bit down. So now you see only sensor information here in this list. So as we can see, here we have two critical events. The first one is called sensor value below normal range. So in the case when Matrix Radar recognizes a device which has a sensor value below normal range, Radar would send you an email. Or sensor value above normal range, Matrix Radar would send you an email as well. Again, this is the email stuff, and I want to show you the email that we received today. I start Firefox, go back. This is my Gmail account for all the status reports from Matrix Radar. As you can see, we started today in the morning at with status reports. It's somewhere like 9 a.m. in the morning. Almost every hour, we get a status report here from the project. And if we are open the report, it shows you exactly what happened a few minutes ago. Again, you saw this. We've got information. We've got this kind of information because the category information was activated for email. So here you see some information, what happened, and also some critical things happened. A sensor value is below the normal range, and the fixture has the IP address of. So this fixture has, or this device has the sensor value below normal range. We go back to a Matrix Radar configuration. So this was the 24/7 monitoring, the big data, and there's one more thing, and this is called patch. Now in the patch, Matrix Radar can patch automatically for you. Very cool, very easy. I go to the other camera because if you look behind me, you maybe see that on this side here, the fixtures, the two rows are maybe not correctly patched. Maybe some guys have seen this during my presentation already. So we want to change the patch for these ones live now. I go to the Matrix software. Now in the Matrix software, we are stopping the queue list. Queue list is stopped, and I change to the queue number 29. So when you take a look at the HeraLED tubes, you see the two lines on the right side have a wrong patch. And to change this, to make it more easy, we are now seeing that the color scroll, which is coming from top, is not working in the right way. Some fixtures, it looks like with some fixtures have wrong addressing, some have maybe a wrong personality, and I want to show you this, how fast you can change this in the Radar patch. Now in the Radar patch, the two rows, one of the rows is DMX universe number 15. If you take a look at the DMX footprint, you see we have three fixtures with a footprint of 96 channels. And you see one device which has this of 8. So when I click this, you will see two actions. Number one is it's auto-identify. So at the tubes, you see this now blinking. And I can change the personality here to 96. And then press Enter. And now, as you can see, the personality is now okay. So I change the personality to the right one. Now, again, if I click a device here in the list, you see it's now the second from the top. This is the last one. It's the first one. And this is this one. So I click the second one. This is, and I move this to the very bottom here. Now I click the first one. It's not okay. This is okay. Now this needs to move up. So we move this fixture up. So radar has click and drag and drop. So as you can see, this is now the fixture number one. This is two. This is three. And this is four. So the row is now correct. But again, as you can see, all of them have DMX start address number one. And of course, we want to change this. There's an easy way for this called auto patch. In the preferences, you click address devices automatically. You click this and boom, the first one has now channel number one because Matrix Radar knows it's 96 channels. The second one is 97. The third one is 193 and the last one is 289. So we fixed this row already. The next row is universe number 16. We go to this row, and here we see a similar situation. The DMX footprint for this fixture is not correct. We change this to 134, press enter. The radar software sends now the information to the fixture. Fixture responded and saved the 144 footprint in the fixture. Problem we have also here with DMX addressing, all of them have DMX start address number one. We are looking at the fixtures. So this is top, this is this, and this is this. So the row, the direction is correct. We click preferences. We are addressing again automatically. Radar knows the footprint. We have 144 channels. So the first fixture got the information, the second one, and the first and the third one. We can close now the software. The color scroll looks okay. We go to the Matrix software. We are double checking the configuration using the other one. Looks beautiful. And I can now press play and the patch is working in the correct way. So Matrix Radar is RDM monitoring 24/7 your email configuration, and you can unleash the full potential of RDM. As you can see, very easy to use, very user-friendly, runs in the background. By using the sensor values, you get value information from all the values, from all the fixtures. You have the auto-patching, everything. So, yes. Matrix Radar runs beautiful with Matrix Stellar devices. So here in Matrix Stellar, you maybe saw this yesterday. This is an ArtNet 2 DMX device. At the bottom, you have two ports. Each port is 512 channels. On the left side, you can connect 512 channels on the right side, and it supports RDM. So Matrix Stellar is in DMX, RDM, and a little Matrix magic. So here in the device runs some Matrix magic that you can run Stellar, Matrix software, and radar all at the same time without visual interruptions. As you can see behind me, the Matrix software was the whole time running. We never shut down the Matrix software. You had no visual interruptions. Everything looks just gorgeous. So for your building, it's just a perfect, perfect solution. The Matrix Stellar, you can also daisy chain, supports daisy chaining. You have two network ports at the very top. You go from the computer to the first device, then you can daisy chain several devices. You can connect up to 40 units of Matrix Stellar to each other. All the Matrix products, not only the software, the Matrix software, the radar software, also all our hardware products are proudly developed and also produced in Germany. And that's for a reason, especially for architectural projects. When you have the buildings. You remember the buildings. You have the pixels on the building, replacing fixtures on the building, replacing ArtNet nodes in the building is very expensive. So for the reason why we are developing the products, all the products in Germany, is this. The average hardware failure and return rate for almost all our hardware products, is below 0.18%, which is industry leading in this lighting industry. So basically no failures over very, very long run in all the architectural environments. To summarize, Matrix Radar is for quick configuration. You saw the configuration in Radar, how easy this is to change personalities, to change addresses, to even change names, things like this. You saw the 24/7 monitoring. Radar can send you emails. You have big data. Big data is a separate license. I will come back in a few moments to this one. And with Matrix Stella connected, you can control not one, not two, not 10. You can control thousands of LEDs on your building, and Radar can run in the background. This is the license for Matrix Radar. And I have good news for you. If you are using Matrix Stella devices, again, RDM, DMX 512, and some Matrix Magic inside, this Matrix Radar is completely free of charge for you when you use Matrix Stella devices, except the big data license. If you want to run Matrix Radar with third-party RDM nodes, well, we can also help you in this case. We have three licenses. The first one is for 32 devices. The second one is for 256 devices. And the last one, the largest one, for 2,048 devices. A device is a fixture, or a device like this is one lamp. If you go on our website to matrix.com, in the download section, you will find Matrix Radar as a free download. And also, if you take a look at the slide, you will see in the middle a demo mode. So you can download Matrix Radar today for free of charge and test with your existing third-party RDM nodes, or if you have a Stella device in your warehouse, you can test this. Two fixtures are in the demo mode supported. So management, configuration, monitoring is supported. And to be 100% clear, if you use Stella, you can test even more than just two devices. Matrix Radar, I showed you this a few moments ago, can send you email reports. So these kind of reports, you can get reports from every project around the world you are doing. So if you are a project company, you are doing architectural projects, you get emails from every project you did when you have Radar running in the background at all the installations. Big data is a separate license. So all the 24/7 monitoring, the email stuff, all this is no charge when you use Stella. Big data is separate. You're buying a Matrix key. You can activate the big data license for looking into the history. So here, with the help of big data, you can take a look at all the sensor values, temperature, voltage, things like this, into the history, like last day, last week, last month, or even last year. This is a one-year license, and you can renew this after 1 year. Now, Matrix Radar and Matrix Stella, you can take advantage of our high-quality software and high-quality hardware, proudly made in Germany, for all your architectural DMX and RDM installations. Now we are at the end of my presentation. Now's the right time to ask me any questions. And I really hope that I can answer and help you to answer all your questions in the next minutes. Do you have any questions? So now is the right time. We will wait some minutes. Again, a reminder for this week. Tomorrow, we have another session at the same time. This will be the new hardware product announcement. And on Friday, the last session for this week, we have also at 4 p.m. German time, the Matrix 5.3 software, all the news which is in this version. So here's the first question now from Matt. When you make patch changes in Radar, does it live modify the patch on a Matrix, on a running Matrix software? No, not yet. So you saw in Radar, I changed the patch, and the patch I didn't touch in Matrix 5 software. So no, it's not live in Matrix software as well. It's only RDM information to the fixture and feedback back from the devices. There's another question from Nicholas. The Matrix Radar sent the DMX address to LedTube or to Matrix software patch? Of course, to the tube here. So Radar is running on the same network like the Matrix software is running. Matrix is responsible just for the beautiful light show, for the effects, all the nice effects you see behind me. This is Matrix software. Radar is sending the information like addressing from the Radar software to the fixture. The fixture responded, and you will see the values in the Radar software as well. Vasily from Russia, will you make Luna with RDM support? Good question. Good question. I think it makes total sense in the future having the Luna range of product to be RDM enabled. Maybe in the future, yes, it's a good idea, Vasily. I think it makes total sense for us. Badu Lighting Designer, what is the longest range you can monitor Radar? Well, Radar sends the information by network. So it's a network cable length. So depending on your network cabling, can be 10 meters, can be 50 meters, can be 100 meters. The cable length, the limitations of network is the information which Radar sends the information with RDM. So I hope this answers your question. Integrated Entertainment Solutions. Very nice to meet you guys here. This is our distribution partner from India. And the question is, can you set alerts on Radar to warn you if, say, a certain parameter like temperature goes very high beyond a set limit? It sends emails, but you can use set it for shut off in such a case. Very good question, and I have a good answer for this. I forgot to show you, but it's possible to send commands, not only you can also send Matrix Windows PowerShell commands. So you saw the email notifications, the email stuff. You can also activate Windows PowerShell. By using Windows PowerShell, you can trigger another system like Control 4 and our control solutions, which are normally running in the building. So Radar can send a signal to such a system. This system can turn off a pixel or shut down the pixel, things like this. So yes, this would be possible using Windows PowerShell. I forgot this to show you, but it's possible. Again, download Matrix Radar, and you can test this by yourself. Hendra Vinata Noor. The question is, the Radar reads sensor feedback per fixture or per LED light? For example, an LED bar with 20 LEDs. You see a lot of LED bars behind me. Everything is called, we call this device, remote device management. It's a device. In each device, you have a lot of LED lights, like 20, 50, 60, 100, whatever it is. So it's Radar reads the sensor information per device and not per LED light, per device. Of course, Sebastian is here helping me with some of the questions. Thank you, Sebastian. Sebastian told me, if you want to see the sensor values like temperature, voltage, things like this in Radar, in the software, your fixture needs to support this. So on the board, you need to have the sensors like temperature, like voltage. If you have the sensors RDM enabled there in the fixture, Matrix Radar can receive and send the questions and receive the data. So next question, again, Nicholas. Can I program all DMX tubes in Radar without an external programmer with three cables? Because with Stellar have ground, dmx plus, and minus. Again, if the fixture is RDM enabled, your device is RDM enabled, you are using Matrix Stella, you can address every single light, no more addressing tools. You can do this by RDM, not a problem. Question number 8, Badru Lighting Designer. Is it possible to set an IP address via radar of any RDM device? Fixtures are RDM devices, and RDM is something different. So possible to set an IP address when radar for any RDM device? No. Yeah, so your RDM device, like the tubes here behind me, this is a DMX light. It has no IP address. It's connected to the Stella, to the DMX port. You saw a few moments before the bottom of a Stella, two DMX ports. These devices are connected to your DMX port. It's not an IP address. The tubes have no IP address. Just the Stella devices have IP addresses. Thank you, Sebastian, for your help. Does radar support any other sensors apart from voltage and temperature sensor? Depends on your fixture manufacturer. Every manufacturer can include the RDM sensor stuff on their devices. And if there are sensors in the device, Matrix Radar will show you automatically all the sensors which are on the, which are part of the PCB design on the devices. So question number 10, Genome Corporation. Do we need any light which is having all sensors or any normal pixel having this feature? Well, again, the devices need to have the sensor value, the sensors on the PCB design. So on the PCBs of these kind of devices, you have the sensors, and Matrix Radar can ask for sensor information, and the fixture can answer by RDM. Not everybody, so it's a lot of RDM devices on the market which have no sensors at all, just RDM for addressing. Does radar support any other sensors apart from voltage and temperature sensors? This was a question a few moments ago. Yes, if your manufacturer supports more information than just temperature and voltage, again, radar asks the fixture, the device, for the sensor values, and the sensor information come to the Matrix radar software. You will see in the radar software all the sensor values automatically. Is Matrix Radar a special LED product? It's a separate software from us. So Matrix software and radar software are two separate software. So if you want to control the pixels, you want to create beautiful light shows, you are using the Matrix software. If you want to monitor 24/7 the email notification, the big data stuff, this is Matrix Radar, another software. We recommend two computers, by the way. So you are running the Matrix software on your first computer, Matrix Radar on a separate computer. That's because of network traffic and other stuff which is going on the network. And if you're doing this, you see a beautiful image here. And again, this is now all live, Matrix software sending live data, radars monitoring all the sensor information from all the devices here in the background, no visual interruptions, it just works. Question 13, what are the differences between Matrix radar and regular Matrix? Again, same, I answered this already. Matrix software is controlling the lights, so you are creating the effects in Matrix. You're creating the light shows in the Matrix software, in Matrix 5. You have Matrix Radar for the RDM stuff, for monitoring your devices, the feedback, big data, and the sensor values. Question number 14, how much costs the radar? Good news, if you are using the Matrix Stella devices, it's free of charge, no license fee except big data. If you use other third-party devices, contact, please, your local dealer in your country. depends on your position. We have the pricing, all the dealer have the information. Please contact your local dealer and he will help you with the cost of Matrix Radar for third-party devices. Question 15. Nicolas, is RDM also possible for SBI technology? Unfortunately not. It's not possible. Badru Lighting Designer, if the output fails on your Stella RDM device, will Radar warn you by email? Not yet implemented. This is one of the first releases of Matrix Radar. Our developers have this already on the list, so you will see this feature very likely in the near future. Thanks, Sebastian. So Matrix Radar will not report if a Stella is disconnected, but it will report you that all the connected Stellas will, if they are not, you know, Matrix Radar cannot find them anymore, then Radar will then send you and inform you about this one by email, of course. Hi, can Radar, Omar Kurtu, I hope I pronounce this right, question number 17. Hi, can Radar show a list of devices that have some issues or sensors near a limit? You saw in the very beginning the graphical overview. So yes, you see this on the first glance on the right side of the software. You saw this. You have a red area, green area, the current values. You see this in the Radar software. No problem. Rob Kirby. Hello, Rob. Rob Kirby is our distribution partner from the UK. Question number 18. Question is, can Radar work with new Aura and Nebulas? Nebulas is an SBI decoder, so no. And Aura is an ArtNet recorder and player. No. So basically no. Radar works with Stellar devices, RDM enabled devices for these kind of RDM devices. Nicolas, again, if I have one computer with two Ethernet cards, can I use Matrix and Radar on the same PC because all units are running in the same network switch? Basically, it's yes, it's possible. Absolutely, you can run Radar on the same computer using two network cards with a Matrix software. Again, our recommendation, because most projects are using just more than one, two, three lights, we are using a lot of devices in the network, our recommendation would be to separate computers. But yes, to answer your question, basically it would be possible. It's not recommended from us, but it would work. I see no more questions now. If you have more questions, then we will wait. We'll wait some more minutes until we shut down. Rob Kirby's question. I'm waiting still for the questions. There's a small delay. What about Radar reading the sensors inside the Nebula, Stella, or Aura, like temperature or voltage out? It's not an RDM device, so it's not in the list. So you see in Matrix Radar RDM devices, and neither Nebula nor Aura is an RDM device, so no. Question 21. Now come more questions. CityLight Egypt. Will Arabic language add to Matrix in the future? Matrix software already supports a lot of different languages like German, English, Italian, Russian, Chinese, and so on. Maybe yes, maybe not. So please send these questions to info@matrix.com by email, and let's have our developers take a look on the implementation, maybe in the near future, maybe not. I can't answer this today. Question 22, Badru Lighting Designer. Is there any fixture personality builder for radar? No. So if you are a manufacturer of these kind of devices, you are storing your personalities in the device, in the firmware of the device. So you can say, I have one personality, two, three, four different modes. You as a manufacturer, you're deciding this. You're storing this information into these devices, and radar can read out this information and display this information. Question 23, Claudio Gianfoni. Greetings to Italy, Claudio. How many fixture can I put in daisy chain in a single output universe? Depends on your devices. So some devices have different modes, like these ones have maybe 96 channels per device. So you can't connect 170, you can connect only a few ones. You have 512 channels per universe. If you have a fixture with 96 channels, you can do the math. So 512 divided by 96, this is your number of devices. The DMIC specification basically is, if you read the DMIC specification, again, DMIC is on the market now since 30 years. In the very beginning, nobody in the world expected installations like this or even architectural buildings, things like this. Nobody who invented the DMIC specification. In the very beginning, in the specification, you can read, if you read the documentation, that only 32 DMIC channels per fixtures per universe are allowed. But this is history. With RGB LEDs, we can control 170 RGB LEDs per universe. So, yes. Question 24, again, Integrated Entertainment Solutions, our distributor from India. Does radar take into account timing using atomic clock? For architectural applications, most architectural fixtures use wireless DMIC. Radar has using the system clock of a computer. So you can set up the time for the email actions, like you want to have emails every 10 minutes, 1 hour, 24 hours. Radar is using the system clock of a computer, and depending on the system clock of a computer, it sends you an email, an alert, or things like this. So if you connect your computer to an astronomical clock, which is normally, if you have the computer connected to the internet, the Windows operating system is automatically changing the system time for you. So yes, radar would use the system time, yes. The second question from Integrated Entertainment System was, most architectural fixtures use wireless DMIC. No, wireless is, I think, not true. Most architectural installation we know is DMIC cabling. We saw a lot of architectural installations the last years. If you go on YouTube, we have a separate place for architectural projects. I think over 90%, 95% or even more is all cabling is DMIC. Some of them are already RDM. Question 25, Robert Kirby. Do you think you will add RDM into Nebula Aura so the whole Matrix range in the future will be RDM? Well, Rob, as you know, SPI LEDs have no sensors, no RDM. It makes no sense to have RDM enabled in the Nebula. Why we should do this if, you know, the devices which you connect to the Nebula are not RDM compatible or cannot send you RDM information. Makes no sense. If you have pixel tape, SPI pixel tape, don't support this. It makes no sense. And I think same for Aura. Radar is designed for these kind of devices which have RDM enabled to get the sensor values for monitoring, things like this. So I've heard that we have more questions, but again, we have a small delay on this. And I wait for new question. Kannst du nochmal rechts im Chat gucken? Also rechts in dem Dokument. So, we are still waiting. Sorry. By the way, Thilo and Franz, both from support team, are working from home office. They are reading the chat and sending me the question to my monitor that I can read the questions and answer questions. Thanks a lot, Thilo. Thanks a lot, Franz, for helping me for this session. And thanks, Sebastian, who is managing here all the cameras, the technic, things like this. Without you, it would not be possible to do things like this. Question number 26. Now we have one. We use with internet browse to anywhere to control radar. Well, if you have a VPN or another solution on your radar computer running, you can remote connect to your Windows system, to your radar software, and to do this, to check the values. But again, the great news about radar is radar sends you the information by email. So you don't need to look at the computer. Radar runs in the background. You don't need a monitor. It sends you the reports. It sends you information about your fixture. You can free configure everything. So there's no need to look at the radar software the whole time. The radar software runs in the background and sends you this information by email. There's another question coming in. From Andy. Question number 27. Andy from China. Hi, Christian. Can radar monitor and manage ArtNet nodes without RDM support or connected RDM devices? If so, is it free for such kind of Matrix devices? No, cannot. So it's not possible. No. So your ArtNet third-party device needs to support RDM. If your ArtNet controller, RDM device, don't support RDM, Matrix radar cannot work. No. Our recommendation again would be the usage of Matrix Stellar, because working in the background with radar and real-time monitoring during live operation, you need this kind of small magic in the devices that it will beautiful work without visual interruptions. Our recommendation would be the usage of Matrix Stellar for these kind of solution. So I see no more questions right now. It's time to say goodbye. Thanks for your time. And I will change my position now. Thanks a lot, guys, for joining the session. Thanks, Sebastian, for the light now in my face, for changing the cameras. Thanks, Sebastian. Thanks, Thilo. Thanks, Franz, staying at home, working from home with the questions for the Q&A session. Thank you all Matrix developers, software developers, hardware developers, the sales team, the marketing team, the whole crew. We are missing you here in the office. We will see you all in the office soon as this COVID-19 situation is over. I want to say now goodbye for you guys. Again, reminder, tomorrow, 4 p.m., same time, same location, different setup here, so the audio will hopefully work from the very beginning. We will test this tomorrow in the morning. We have a hardware product launch tomorrow at 4 p.m. German time. And on Friday, the last session for this week, we have Matrix 5.3. You will see all the new features in the new upcoming Matrix 5.3. Also a long Q&A session. Thanks a lot for joining the session. It's time to say goodbye. See you soon somewhere. Stay healthy. Thank you. Goodbye. Thank you.
We'll be right back.